They've reached the top of the mountain! They are the Stanley Cup champs!
It's so hard to win because everything has to fall into place. Everything has to go right. Everything. It just seems like it's unattainable. When you finally win, you can't believe it. It's the greatest feeling in the world.
I love you, boys. Thank you.
But the big thing for me is you can't be full. If you win one cup, are you full? Or are you still hungry?
From an unprecedented Stanley Cup in a bubble to a season unlike any other, at a time when we really could use something to cheer about.
Hold on to hope, don't be afraid of the dark. Just breathe in the air, and light will come for you tonight. We both got scars, and it's so hard to understand. When there is light in me, just open up our eyes.
They are going to punch their ticket to the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Welcome back!
The defending champs will be part of the Final Four.
I will carry you home, back to the fold. Shoulder to stone in the skin and bones. Give you my all, never.
Back to the Stanley Cup Final!
A diving play by Blake Coleman!
No!
Lightning strikes twice! The Tampa Bay Lightning win their second straight Stanley Cup!
In September 2020, when the Tampa Bay Lightning returned home from the NHL bubble in Edmonton with the Stanley Cup, the city of Tampa celebrated the second championship in franchise history. But shortly after the festivities ended, reality set in, as the entire hockey world was again faced with finding a way through the ongoing COVID-19 global pandemic.
It's been tough, you know, but away from the rink, you know, you're not supposed to do a whole lot and you're not allowed to do a whole lot.
Staying safe and making sure your teammates are staying safe to get through it, obviously going through all the protocols and testing and making sure you're doing the right things to move forward.
To move forward with the 2020-2021 season, the NHL and the NHL Players Association reimagined the typical hockey season. Divisions would be realigned, and teams in those divisions would face off entirely against each other. The league would consist of the Mass Mutual East Division, the Scotia North Division, the Honda West Division, and the Lightning would be one of the 8 teams to make up the Discover Central Division. The 82-game regular season was cut down to 56 games, starting in January rather than October. Only this time, there would be no bubble. Teams would play in their home arenas, in most places without fans.
Hockey is meant to be watched live. When you pulled the fans out, it did pull something out of the game.
Also missing at the start of the season would be Tampa Bay's top offensive weapon, Nikita Kucherov. Still recovering from off-season hip surgery that would eventually require him to miss the entire regular season.
Trust me, our team didn't want Cooch out for the whole regular season, and Cooch didn't want to be out for the regular season. Great, you won the Stanley Cup, but now you're going to have a surgery and you're going to be out for 8 months. No player is checking that box saying, yeah, let that happen.
The loss of Kucherov would be difficult to overcome. but the Lightning would also receive some positive preseason news. After playing only a handful of minutes in last year's playoffs, the captain, Steven Stamkos, would return to the lineup.
He was with us the whole time, playing 3 minutes in total.
He scores! My goodness, right out of a storybook!
Stammer made his imprint on the series that's been well documented last year, but I think he'll be the first one to tell you he would have rather been a part of the 20 plus games we played.
As a player, as an athlete, you know, as the captain of the team, you want to be out there with your teammates.
Good evening and welcome to opening night at Amalie Arena.
In sports, they say trophies are for the team, rings are for the players, and banners are for the fans. So we've decided to wait to raise our 2020 banner to the rafters until after our fans are back inside of our house.
16 weeks, 16 playoff spots available, and tonight a title defense starts in Tampa. Tampa Bay, off and running.
And it's an onslaught by the Lightning early.
It was a hard year, you know, a lot of back-to-backs, a lot of every other day. It was a 56-game condensed schedule, and it was hard.
Well, the Lightning have now played 11 games, and they are 9-1-1. It's hard to imagine a better start. It is the Lightning and Nashville Predators tonight at Amalie Arena, but not just a hockey game, Phil. We have the first game this year in which fans are in the building, right. 3,800.
Saturday night, fans in the stands.
They are going to raise the banner to the Raptors.
You guys don't know how much we've missed you. To all the fans that are here tonight, to the distant Thunder, to everyone watching, this banner's for you guys, so thank you.
2 months into the season, with fans back in the seats, and the Lightning just a point out of first place, excitement began to build, helped along by the continued excellence of goaltender Andre Vasilevsky.
Vasilevsky now owns the franchise record for longest consecutive shutout streak. Andre Vasilevsky, new franchise record, his 12th consecutive win.
Tampa Bay has skated in 40 games, just 16 remain, and once again, prior to the trade deadline, Tampa Bay made a major move today.
My thought was, if I have the opportunity to acquire David Savard, and I pass up on that opportunity, and then, you know, the playoffs start, and eventually we fail in our quest for a championship because our right side D wasn't good enough, that was going to hurt. That was going to hurt a lot.
I'm really excited to be on a team that has a chance to win the Stanley Cup and be part of a run again.
Eddie's mic'd up, dude.
Watch out, watch out. 1-2, test, 1-2.
But even before David Savard could make a meaningful impact on the ice, the Lightning were dealt a serious blow.
Cause for concern, however, with the captain and Steven Stamkos early in the third period in what looked to be an innocent dump-in. Stammer suddenly stops at the blue line and did not return. He left the ice.
While Stamkos' late-season injury meant he'd miss time, it did allow others to break into the lineup, like 24-year-old Ross Colton, who became only the ninth player in franchise history to score a goal in his NHL debut.
He's been outstanding for this team. It's really hard to think of where this team would be in the last 2 weeks if Ross Colton wasn't in the lineup.
Put it in front, Colton, backhand shot, score!
And guess who? Ross Colton!
And it's gonna be tough when hopefully you get Stamkos, hopefully you get Kucherov back and those guys are 100%.
I don't see how you take Ross Colton out at this point. He leads this team for goals right now in the month of April. He's been a revelation for this team.
With production now coming from unexpected sources, as well as Tampa Bay's usual suspects.
Victor Hedman with a Lightning strike!
The Lightning would finish third in the Central Division and earn the chance to defend their crown.
I can hear the sound of thunder. I can hear the sound of rain. I can see the bright white lightning coming down to strike me again.
They win it, and the Lightning, it's official, are going back to the Stanley Cup playoffs.
After a 56-game regular season filled with unbelievable goals and breathtaking saves, an historic outdoor event, and an all-time milestone set.
Patrick Marleau, number one.
Passing Gordie Howe to become the all-time leader in games played in the National Hockey League.
Tampa Bay was joined in the playoffs by 15 other teams, each skating for the chance to raise Lord Stanley's cup. About 250 miles away from Tampa, in South Florida, the Lightning would begin the defense of their Stanley Cup championship against the Panthers, their formidable cross-state rivals.
The Florida Panthers had a tremendous regular season. They also have the talent and depth to keep pace with the Lightning in this first round series. It's round one, game one tonight between the Lightning and Panthers.
Florida fans have been waiting for this one, and it is finally here. The first ever playoff meeting between the Lightning and the Panthers.
The Lightning were without Nikita Kucherov all season, but the league's MVP 2 years ago has finally rehabbed from off-season hip surgery.
Steven Stamkos back in the lineup after missing the last 16 games.
These two teams have never met in the Stanley Cup playoffs until right now.
Early on, Game 1 would take on a decidedly physical tone. And while the Lightning did gladly welcome back two of their biggest stars, it was Blake Coleman who would break the ice, scoring the first goal of the series, shorthanded.
Big gun out to Yanni Gordon center. Coleman in alone!
Beautiful backhand by Blake Coleman.
But the Lightning wouldn't hold the lead for long as they were unable to stop the Panthers' relentless attack.
Crosby's Barkov, he scores from the right circle. Carter Barkov open, puts it to the slot, Verhaeghe scores. Carter Verhaeghe's made it 2-1 Panthers.
The second period, however, would belong to Nikita Kucherov. Playing his first game in more than 7 months, Kucherov would make his presence felt, especially on the power play.
Stamkos left circle, center point, Edmund, right circle, Kucherov. Score! Kucherov! Welcome back!
Another tag team, here's Edmund across! They score! And it's Kucherov, his second goal of the night!
In a surprisingly wild seesaw affair that would have four lead changes, the two teams battled down the stretch.
Kucherov. He's in front! Score! Brayden Point!
Finally, with time winding down and the game tied at four, Tampa Bay found itself with the opportunity to pull ahead again. This time, for good.
Score! Brayden Point! 5-4 Lightning with 1:14 left to go! And it's over! The Lightning win game one! 5-4!
I forgot how fun the playoffs are. Our offense will come. It'll come just how it came in the end.
It's good to have Cooch back.
Yeah. Quite a hockey game. Two exceptional teams going at it, and that's why it's the greatest sport in the world.
After giving up 5 goals in Game 1, the Panthers made a change in the net for Game 2, replacing Sergei Bobrovsky with Chris Drieger.
Ring the bell between Florida and Tampa Bay.
But the switch didn't help much, as Steven Stamkos put the Lightning on top just 5 minutes into the first period.
Ballard, Stamkos, back in set, and he scores! Tampa Bay has opened the scoring on a goal by the captain.
Throughout much of the rest of the opening period, the two teams traded chances, until Andre Palat pounced on a rebound to extend the Tampa Bay lead. As the minutes went by, the physicality intensified on both sides. After the first period, Tampa Bay would leave the ice with a two-goal advantage, and it would stay that way until late in the second, when the Panthers finally got on the board.
Front score! Marchment! The Panthers cut the Lightning lead in half.
The rest of the way, however, the Lightning slammed the door shut in a total team effort.
This is vintage what they did last year in the playoffs. So many times in every series, protecting one goal lead has been outstanding.
They played a strong defensive game tonight in front of their goalie. Blocking shots, great performance.
Yanni Gourde's empty net goal sealed the deal as the Lightning skated off with a 2-0 series lead.
A real solid game for the Tampa Bay Lightning. A good start offensively and a solid victory all the way around. They take a 2-0 lead in this series.
Championship teams win 5-4 games and they can win the 2-1 games. And that's what you're doing.
To get two wins and come home to our amazing fans is really exciting for us. We're pumped. Hopefully they're as loud as ever.
While the return of Steven Stamkos and Nikita Kucherov were paying immediate dividends, the Lightning returned to Tampa for Game 3, hoping to get a boost from yet another return. For the first time in more than 2 years, a playoff game at Amalie Arena would be played in front of fans.
We welcome those of you who have just joined us as we get set for Game 3 of this first round series.
But it was the visiting Panthers who got off to a fast start.
Jonathan Huberdeau, centering pass, score!
Let's go!
Shot by Gudas, score! 2-0 Florida!
Down two, midway through period two, the Lightning offense finally came to play.
Kedman with some room, shoots, score! Anthony Cirelli. Colton with the puck once again, shoots and scores! McDonough towards the net, score! Beautiful setup, and the Lightning take a 3-2 lead.
But just 4 minutes later, with the Panthers on the power play, the game would be tied again.
Yeah! Keep pushing the pace, eh, boys? Keep going here.
Once more, however, Tampa Bay's torrid offensive onslaught continued, eventually setting a franchise record with 5 goals in a single playoff period. And up two, with just 20 minutes to play, Tampa Bay had to like its chances. But Florida had other ideas.
Moving in his Forsling with a shot! He scores! Gustav Forsling ties the game at 5!
In overtime, both sides had numerous opportunities, but both goaltenders were equal to the task. Until a rare defensive lapse ended Tampa Bay's night.
Panthers clear the puck out. Moving in with a shot as Lundberg, he scores! Ryan Lundberg with the overtime winner.
No one's worried in our locker room. We know that they're a good team. I think, you know, there's certain things we can do better when we get that lead in the third period. We'll come in tomorrow, we'll watch some video, and we'll be ready Saturday.
Game 4, Lightning and Panthers on this Saturday afternoon at Amalie Arena.
Time now for playoff hockey. They're going to try to head to Sunrise with a 3-1 series lead.
Shaking off an overtime loss is never easy. Although, with a quick start in Game 4, the Lightning hope to do just that.
Cirelli's along! Shoot! Score! Cirelli! Tipped in front by Yanni Gourde! 2-0 Lightning!
Just more than a minute after Tampa Bay would take a swift 2-goal lead, the Panthers retaliated.
Wide open for Jonathan Huberdeau.
But determined to finish the period strong, Andre Palat kept the momentum going.
Palat on the tip! The Lightning make it 3-1!
With 3:15 left in the first!
In the second, the Lightning would not rest on their laurels as they continued to stay aggressive.
Let's go! Alex, come on! Taps it in!
Boy, what hustle from Stamkos and a beautiful pass to Kalorn.
Score! Kalorn another!
It's 5-1 with 12:45 left in the second.
In the third period, Florida continued to push hard. But again, Vasilevsky stood tall, stopping all but two of 41 shots.
Vasilevsky to save and the rebound. He's got it.
In the end, however, the Lightning offense proved to be too powerful, especially Nikita Kucherov, who finished off Florida with his first goal and fourth point of the game.
Kucherov! 4 points today!
This one is over. Andrei Vasilevsky's amazing.
Amazing.
The statement win for Vasilevsky.
You were going through a lot of adversity, fellas. It was everywhere. And you guys passed the test in every situation. Penalty kill sick. Power play outstanding. That's what you have to do to win a playoff series.
Heading into Game 5, the Lightning would have a chance to finish off their in-state rival.
For the Florida Panthers, it's desperate times, call for desperate measures. Starting the 20-year-old Spencer Knight in goal. That should grab the attention of everybody on the Florida Panthers bench. Let's see if this move by Joel Quenneville is able to spark this Panthers team.
With the fate of their season resting squarely on the shoulders of a rookie goaltender just 2 months out of college, the Panthers staved off elimination to force a Game 6.
Well, the Lightning wanted to see this end tonight. It's not going to happen, and what is a spectacular series will continue with a Game 6 on Wednesday in Tampa. Florida Panthers take this one and stay alive.
We talked about this from the beginning. That's a really good hockey team over there. They weren't going to just roll over and die. It's two really good hockey teams going at it. We knew it was going to be a tough series from the beginning. We'll expect a better effort from our group next game.
The Lightning might not have closed out the series in five, but there was a silver lining. They could now clinch their first series at home since 2018, and they would have some help. Making a return to the lineup was Barclay Goodrow, an integral piece of the 2020 Stanley Cup run.
The Tampa Bay Lightning trying to advance to the second round. Here we go.
Last year, the Lightning learned it took a total team effort to have success in the Stanley Cup playoffs. And in Game 6, they would follow that script. Four different players would score a goal. Nine with at least 1 point. Steven Stamkos would score his third goal of the playoffs on the power play.
An absolute bullet from Stamkos!
Nikita Kucherov would cap off a dominant first-round performance with a two-point night, giving him 11 for the series.
Kucherov waves his magic wand again!
And in what would become a signature of each of Tampa Bay's series-clinching wins, Andrei Vasilevsky would stop all 29 shots. It all added up to the fifth straight series win for a team that looked poised to make another deep run in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
And the champs are moving on to the second round.
It was 60 minutes of just sheer will and compete. To win in this league, that's what you need. When you make the playoffs, you need it from everybody, and the players gave it. The boys played like champions today.
Winning the Battle of Florida was the Lightning's first step in defending their title. And as they moved closer to their goal of claiming back-to-back cups, their next opponent would be even tougher. The team that won the Central Division, the Carolina Hurricanes.
Coming to you live from PNC Arena, site of Game 1 of the second round series between the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Carolina Hurricanes.
They're allowing people back in, and everybody is so excited to finally get together, and you'll be able to hear it. You'll be able to hear it out here.
The Tampa Bay Lightning and Carolina Hurricanes were the two best teams in the Central Division.
Where these teams differ, I think, are star power and goaltending. The Hurricanes don't have a player like Nikita Kucherov or even Braden Point.
It's the division champs against the defending champs. They split the season series with 4 wins apiece. Round 2, Game 1 underway.
Normally, the opening game of a series starts slow, but in this one, a feeling out process would not be needed.
Evan Holt.
Shoot! Score! It was tipped in front by Braden Point!
The Lightning take a 1-0 lead. They confirm the power play with 11:45 left in the second.
Carolina had multiple chances to tie the game, but again and again, they'd be denied by Andrei Vasilevsky.
The shot was smothered there by Vasilevsky as Trocheck didn't get a lot on it.
until early in the third period, when the Hurricanes would finally beat the seemingly unbeatable.
Here's Bean with a shot. Score! Jake Bean on the power play. It's tied!
The crowd here is pumped up.
In just his second game back from injury, Barclay Goodrow, one of the Lightning's best defensive players, went on the offensive.
Barclay Goodrow to the outside with a shot. He scores! And with 7:21 to go, Tampa has a 2-1 lead.
You know, usually doesn't get his accolades from getting game-winning goals. He's usually the guy stopping game-tying goals.
This one's over! The Lightning win game one! 2-1!
I saw Gordo driving the net. I was really just looking to get the puck on net, maybe, you know, create a rebound for him, and just found a way to go in.
We get you set for game two of Tampa Bay's second round playoff series. Earlier today, Andrei Vasilevskiy was announced as a finalist for the Vezina Trophy. It's his fourth consecutive year.
Caroline understands going down 0-2 is not an option, which is why the Lightning need to be ready for the Canes' best shots in game two.
Push our will on them, all right? Let's get greedy tonight and take this one and go home and have your boys.
Ready for game number two in Raleigh, North Carolina.
With another full building fully behind them, the Hurricanes would come out aggressive.
Let's go!
Looking to set an early tone.
Come on, boys! Let's go, let's go, let's go! Relentless all night, all night!
But once again, Vasilevskiy would continue to elevate his game against what would become a relentless Carolina attack.
Yeah, yeah, yeah! Be shooters, keep firing! Hey, we gotta keep these away from the goalie, boys!
On this night, however, the Hurricanes' rookie goaltender, Alex Nedeljkovic, was up for the challenge.
Save made by Nedeljkovic, and he covered the rebound before Kucherov could poke it in.
Desperately trying to overcome the strong play of Nedeljkovic, the Lightning's potent offense would continue to attack.
Shoot, score! Klorn!
For the second straight game, the Lightning take a 1-0 lead into the locker room after 40 minutes.
Protect the slot. Remember, strong side winger has to be in the lane. Has to be. All right, 20 to goal here, boy.
Come on, White.
Works it to Cirelli at center. Cirelli across the blue line, a step toward the slot. Back a shot. Score! 2-0 Lightning! Wow. A huge goal for Anthony Cirelli with 11:54 left in the third.
Cirelli, I like that a lot.
Now up two in the final minutes. Tampa Bay would have to withstand one final frantic push.
It's Hamilton to the front. They score! Yeah! And with 90 seconds to go, it's a one-goal game.
A lot of time left.
On him!
15 seconds left. Hamilton to the center point. Left circle, Nages. Nages holds. Nages puts it in front. Deflected by Skull.
Save by Vasilevskiy!
And the whistle comes at 1.6.
This one is over! The Lightning win game two! 2-1!
That's gonna be Warriors, and you guys are Warriors. Massive penalty kill, big draws at the end, blocked shots.
Come in here and get both wins was huge. We know how hard it is to win this time of the year, period. We get to come home in front of our fans that are going to be just as rowdy.
Back at home for Game 3 in Tampa, the Lightning hope to continue their good fortune.
The defending Stanley Cup champions own a 2-0 lead in the best-of-7 series and are looking to take a commanding 3-0 lead with a victory tonight as the series shifts to Tampa.
The largest crowd of the season here in Tampa awaits. And tonight, with their backs against the wall, Rod Brindamore goes to Peter Mrazek in net.
Puck is dropped, we're underway.
Playing with a clear sense of urgency, Carolina was finally able to strike first.
Svechnikov for Pesci. He scores! And it is 1-0 Carolina. It's the first time they have led in the series. This one comes to Aho. He darts in. Aho scores! And it is 2-0 Hurricanes.
But after falling behind for the first time in the series, Tampa Bay would come storming back.
Seam pass. They score!
Shoot! Save Mrazek. Klorn!
As it turned out, Alex Killorn's goal was the Lightning's last of the night, as Peter Mrazek would keep the Lightning off the board.
Poked on Kucherov. Saved by Mrazek. 6 seconds to go. Headbutt! Glove down by Mrazek! Danzig.
For the first time in the series, we will have overtime.
Desperate to avoid going down 3-0, early in overtime, it was Carolina that broke through.
They set up Aho. He scores! And it's a 2-1 series lead for Tampa as Carolina picks up the win in game 3.
We had our chance. We didn't score on ours. They had theirs. They capitalized. That's kind of what it comes down to. For the most part, I liked our game. I liked our compete. You know, give Carolina credit. They played hard as well. They got this one.
After 3 consecutive close contests, from the start, game 4 would take on a decidedly different tone.
Guys, hold on, hold on, hold on.
Hoagland, Coleman, jostle.
That's both of them. Sit them both down. 2 minutes to run sportsmanlike conduct.
Late in the first period, Tampa Bay took an early lead, thanks to Braden Point's 7th goal of the playoffs.
Braden Point makes it 1-0, Tampa Bay!
Nice play, man. What a play. That line is buzzing, bud.
Come on, boys. Let's get to work here.
But that just foreshadowed the offensive explosion to come in period 2.
They score! We are tied at 1! Shattering Tampa scores! Carolina leads it!
With both teams scoring seemingly at will.
You gotta get out there, boys! Turn up and go north!
Score! Stamkos!
Pop that one in, it's 2-2.
Slavin makes it 4-2, Carolina!
This has been one of the Lightning's worst sequences in the series so far.
Let's just calm down and take a breath, okay? Some unlucky bounces. We'll get one on the PP right here. It's a 1-goal game. We're not getting the bounces, but we're not working hard enough either.
Now it's Evie score! Kucherov!
Right, so go to Johnson. Fire score! Score!
Yes!
Tyler Johnson has tied this game in 4!
Eventually, as the wild period came to a close, it would be Stamkos who followed his own words.
Let's go, Stam. Get on it.
Right circle, Kucherov open. Left circle, Stamkos. Score! Stamkos!
Yes! 5-4 Lightning! With 22.4 seconds left in the second.
And when the Lightning added one more in the third to go up 6-4, the Hurricanes would find themselves on the brink.
Game is winding down. A shot block from Gord on Geeky. This one is over. The Lightning win it. And they leave the series 3-1.
You came back to life, and it was outstanding what you did. But you're going to see, fourth one's the toughest one to get, boys. Right? And we're just going to have to take another step. But you've got the recipe. You know how to do it.
G-Dub.
Stay. Defending Stanley Cup champion Lightning are 1 win away from a trip to the semifinals. You better start running, you'll never see it coming. You better start running like your life depending on it. You better start running, you'll never see it coming. Go on, boys, let's go here! It's gonna flash a light on your life. Over Point, had to go to the backhand, he scores! A power play goal by Braden Point, and Tampa has a 1-0 lead.
Chris Golden! He makes it 2-0 Lightning! Another shutout for Andrei Vasilevsky in a series clinching victory. They win game 5 2-0, they win the series 4-1, and they are back to the final 4.
This is.
You know, if you want me to just throw a whole bunch of cliches out there, I can. Take them all, ball them all up into one, and that's the effort that these guys gave. You need that if you want to advance, because I'm going to tell you, those are 2 of the toughest rounds we've ever faced. And it was a hell of a grind to get out of this division.
The 4 teams that survived the division round would now meet in the semifinals.
Hey, boys.
The surprising Montreal Canadiens would take on the powerful Vegas Golden Knights, while for the second year in a row, Tampa Bay's opponent would be the New York Islanders. As the summer heat intensified in Tampa, so too would the competition. With eager fans flooding Amalie Arena, the Lightning would find themselves facing a knockdown, drag-out battle against an all-too-familiar foe.
Welcome inside Abilene Arena in Tampa. Game one, semifinal round. New York Islanders, Tampa Bay Lightning.
For the first time since beating them in last year's conference final, Tampa Bay would face the well-structured and impeccably coached New York Islanders, a team out for revenge.
We better buckle up because it's going to be one heck of a series.
This will be a forechecking series. Grind it out in our D zone. Don't give an inch. It's an unreal environment out there. Let's go play the game, boys.
Here we go, boys.
Have a great series, men. Underway 8 seconds in, and we got some pushing and shoving as Cal Clutterbuck going at it with Sergachev, who knocks the helmet off his head.
Early on, physicality and elite goaltending would be on full display.
Oh, left circle, Pajot, saved by Vasilevsky, rebound in front, saved by Vasilevsky, and Palmieri!
19, get out of there, you got the... You want to join him?
And it would take more than half the game to open the scoring.
And the lead pass for Barzal. Moving in, he shoots and scores! 1-0 Islanders, Matthew Barzal.
Eventually, the Islanders would add another, while their goaltender, Semyon Varlamov, kept Tampa Bay scoreless until the final minute of play.
Puck played by Kucherov, front for point, he shoots and scores!
But for the Lightning, one goal wouldn't be enough to prevent falling behind in a series for the first time in the postseason.
And that will do it. The Islanders take game one.
We knew it was going to be extremely tough. There's definitely no panic in this room, but we do realize that it's going to be an extremely tight series. We just have to expect that going forward.
Looking to even the series in game two, Tampa Bay's emotions would be riding high, especially for Blake Coleman and his family, who had added a new Lightning fan prior to the game.
Game one, that morning, around 10 o'clock or so, I got the confirmation that it was go time, and with the 3 o'clock game, there was some decisions to be made, and, you know, she encouraged me and pushed me towards playing.
Oh, come here, Lewis.
Right after the game, obviously, I just tried to speed out of there as quick as possible.
This is Carson Elizabeth Coleman. She is 35 hours old.
I'm excited to play my first game with Carson Rupp.
Lightning and Islanders, game two tonight.
I don't want this to sound, oh, we weren't mentally sharp, that's why we lost the game. The Islanders, give them a ton of credit. Laid a bit of an egg in game one, but I don't anticipate that happening tonight.
Kucherov in front, point! Point!
Shoot, save me! Rebound shot! Save Vasilevsky on Palmieri!
Now Martin is ready to fight with Maroon.
I'm not letting go of you once they got you. Go, Marty!
Kelly, cross-ice pass broken up, and then Nelson scores!
And we're tied at one.
But thanks to Andre Palat.
Kucherov makes a little move.
A feed in front, Palat! Score! Great feed from Kucherov to Palat, it's 2-1 Lightning!
And some resurrected offense from the blue line. Tampa Bay would tie the series, improving to 4-0 in the postseason in games following a loss.
That's what we pride ourselves in. After you lose one game, you want to get back at it, and I thought that was a good example of a hungry team getting ready to go out there and battle.
We didn't hope tonight, we worked tonight.
Excited to go up to Long Island and keep it going.
When the series shifted north, the Lightning arrived on Long Island only to be greeted by an insatiable Nassau Coliseum crowd, hungry for victory.
Well, here at Nassau Coliseum tonight, for the first time in 28 years, a game in the semifinal round, it will be an electric atmosphere.
No doubt the Islanders will get a boost from the home crowd tonight. The Lightning are 5-1 in games away from Amalie Arena in the playoffs.
Tampa Bay would open the scoring with a goal by Yanni Gourde.
Gourde had Varlamov leading the wrong way, he buries it, and it's one of the Lightning.
Yeah, let's go!
And after Braden Point scored late in the second period, the sixth straight game with a goal, the Bolts successfully protected their slim 2-1 lead for the entirety of the final period.
Let's go!
That was a great game.
Nice job, boys.
so important to get the lead, fellas. You did it. We needed a start. We got it. All right. Hell of a job.
It's a Saturday night in New York. Game 4, where the Islanders hope to even the series and ensure tonight won't be the final chapter for Nassau Coliseum.
For the Lightning, Game 4 would present a golden opportunity to take a stranglehold on the series. But feeding off the intensity of their energetic fans, the Islanders had other plans.
You guys know what I want. Get that over. All right, good. Woo! Good.
Sticks on the ice. We forecheck.
Three unanswered goals by New York would stun Tampa Bay, sending them into the second intermission, searching for their game.
Everybody take a breath. All right, we are a flooding team and a weak side D up team. That's how you beat them. Let's play the game more north with a little more pace here, boys. All right, let's go.
Pointer.
He braided point with speed and comes across the blue line. Right circle shot. Score!
Goals in 7 straight games now, and he makes it 3-1.
Soon after, Tyler Johnson would cut the deficit to 1 as the Lightning looked poised for a comeback. But with time winding down, the hockey gods would not smile upon the Bolts.
Down to 5. Puck comes out to McDonough. Has the game on his stick. Oh! What a block in front by Pollock! The Islanders win game 4. We're going back to Tampa with a series tied.
I'm proud of the guys for the push in the third, but that was a bit of a heart stopper at the end. Fortunately, it didn't go our way.
Fueled by a dramatic and disappointing end to Game 4, the Lightning would return to Tampa with fans buzzing, ready for redemption.
Come on, Blue! Come on, Blue! Let's go, boys! Here we go!
Big Cat!
This has been a tight series, and they're going to need a game breaker like Stamkos. Can Stamkos have a breakout game? That'll be the key.
Yeah, we're going to go right down on the ice!
Go to Stamkos. Stamkos holds. High slash for Horn. A shot block. Rebound. Stamkos. Score!
And
one. Put it in front. Score!
Tampa Bay's 3-goal first period would spell the end of the night for Isles goaltender Semyon Varlamov. But even up big, the Lightning refused to relent.
And then left circle, Stamkos! Score! 4-0 Lightning!
After Tampa Bay added 2 more goals in the second, another by Braden Point in the third would extend his goal streak to 8 straight games as the Lightning decimated the Islanders.
Lightning have tied the franchise record for most goals in a playoff game.
That's a good look at scoreboard.
Great game.
I truly believe the response you guys gave in the third period the other night carried right over to this. You played with passion, you played with brothers, and you played on a mission of what our goal is.
One more, good fellow. Great one.
The fourth win of a 7-game series is always the hardest to earn. And with a chance to close out the Islanders and shut down Nassau Coliseum for good, the Lightning expected desperation from the home side in Game 6.
Game number 6 on the island.
What they didn't expect was losing Nikita Kucherov on his very first shift of the game with an injured rib.
It's a major story for Kucherov. He only played 48 seconds.
But despite having to play without their leading scorer for the rest of the night, it was the Lightning who would still strike first.
Left circle for Point. Back in shot. Score!
Braden Point! Goals in 9 straight games!
Point's scoring streak would put him 1 game away from tying an NHL record that stood for 45 years.
Come on, let's go, boys!
Lot. Up the left side, Cirelli, a step across the blue line, left circle, cutting in front, score!
Yes! Cirelli!
After taking a 2-0 lead, the Lightning looked like they were well on their way to taking the series, but the Islanders had other ideas.
Mayfield, he scores! Mayfield ties it!
We're going to
have overtime for the first time in the series.
A little over 1 minute into overtime, New York would end the game, dashing Tampa Bay's hopes for a clinch.
Now off a giveaway, score! Anthony Beauvillier sends the Islanders down to Tampa for Game 7.
It sucks to lose Cooch like that early in the game. And, you know, we didn't get the job done tonight, but we get to go back in front of our fans.
We're going to go out there and battle, have our best game of the year.
After missing out on all of last year's closeout opportunities, back in Tampa for the crucial Game 7, Lightning fans were more than ready to bring the thunder. And so was head coach John Cooper. Although in advance of his team's first elimination game this postseason, he was a bit more steady and calm.
You can't let the moment engulf you. It's your trust in what you've done to get you to this point.
I think I get all the nerves. He does not really worry.
Okay, see you guys tonight.
All right,
Dad. All right, love you. All right. You can't look at it as you're winning a series. You're just looking at it as, let's just go win this hockey game.
Make sure we're taking this to them. And in the end, fellas, we'll do what you guys do. Let's go.
To the relief of the fans, Kucherov's return would mean a full roster of firepower ready for battle.
Hunt him down!
Race for the puck. Beauvillier has it. Deech, and it's stopped.
Big time save there by Vasilevsky.
L.A. Roscoe! L.A. Roscoe!
Players continue to battle in a scoreless game.
Voracek has been good for Tampa early on in this game.
Anthony Cirelli shorthanded. Cirelli beats Gordon in front!
Shorthanded goal! 1-0 Lightning!
Right, baby!
On this night, Yanni Gourde's goal would be all the Bolts would need to bury the Isles, as Andrei Vasilevsky would get his fourth straight series-clinching shutout.
Rebound Nelson, right corner, trying to center it, loose in front, Palat gets it, he's out of the zone! Yeah! The Lightning are going back to the Stanley Cup Final!
Way to go, boys!
Elbow drop! Everything we had.
Unbelievable,
sir.
Way to go, right now.
Hey. Don't win it all
now. A disciplined team effort, combined with a rising tide of fan energy, had lifted the Lightning to their second straight Stanley Cup final. Awaiting them were the surprising Montreal Canadiens.
We're going back to the finals.
I'm happy to hand this one out. G-Dub. Yeah. I've never heard a building as loud as I did tonight in that last minute play, ever. It was electric. Fans came to play tonight as just as our team did.
Tampa, Florida. In recent times, Tampa has been the home of champions in North American team sports. Inside Amalie Arena, there will be 16,300 excited fans as the Lightning try to go back-to-back, standing in their way, Montreal Canadiens.
The Montreal Canadiens were the last team to qualify for the postseason. They were left nearly for dead when they were down 3-1 to the Toronto Maple Leafs in the first round. They reeled off 7 straight wins, 11 wins in their last 13 to defeat the Leafs, to sweep the Jets, and then the Vegas Golden Knights in the Stanley Cup semifinal to get here.
This Montreal team just came together at exactly the right time. They don't have the star power. They have some experienced guys in Staal and Perry that have won Stanley Cups, but it is the young guys that are doing it.
Here we go, fellas.
The Lightning have to know that, yeah, they are good, and you better not underestimate them.
Let's go, Larry. Let's have a night.
They're dangerous.
We've been here before, fellas. You know what to expect. Channel your Game 7 emotions right into Game 1. All right, fellas, let's go here, boys.
Gotta love the drama, don't you? Two great goaltenders, two teams playing at the top of their game, and four wins to win the most coveted cup in sport.
There we go, boys! Great start here, come on!
Head coach Dominic Ducharme testing positive for COVID-19. He's not behind the bench to start the series. Luke Richardson will.
And we are ready to go, underway, the Stanley Cup Final, Lightning and Canadiens.
Here we go, boys, come on out, let's be going, who goes beat?
Here's Cole Caulfield, in with a shot, that missed the net high.
Vasilevsky has no idea where that puck is.
Settle, boys, settle!
Where's that puck? Blatt stays with it, gave it away, Toffoli in the slot, shoots over the net! Lightning struggling in their own zone early in this game.
Hey, Pointer!
Here comes Braden Point. Point with a goal in 9 of the last 10 games.
All playoffs long, Braden Point has been a game breaker for the Lightning. Normally the one scoring the goals. But just 6 minutes into game one, it would be his defensive play that kickstarted the offense.
Cole Caulfield, he looked to set a Petrie. Good back check. Point steals. Counters for Turnak. Left wing Andre Palat. Across the blue line, left circle in front. Turnak! Score! Turnak! What a tip! 1-0 Lightning with 13:41 left in the first.
Braden Point was the one that started
with
a
great back check.
And a nice little deflection by Turnak.
A big hit from Josh Anderson.
Get out of here.
We're so scared.
Absolute mammoth hit.
Gallagher is going to try and create some chaos, and he ends up in the Lightning net.
Hey! You're tripping me! You have the same amount of points as me, buddy! That's embarrassing! Hey, we wear them down. Wear those teams down, boys. Every shift.
Stamkos back to the point. Hedman looks and fires. And a big glove save by Price. Textbook shift by the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Chernak walks in and fires through a crowd loose.
Another good opportunity for the Lightning.
They may not go in this first period. They will by the third.
First period in the books. Tampa Bay Lightning on a goal by Eric Chernak. 1-0.
All right, so you got a feel for how this is going here. That's only one fellow's long way to go. Get him here, boys. Let's go.
Woo! Here we go, boys.
Here we go, round two.
With the play going its way, Tampa Bay would begin the second period just as it ended the first, seemingly in total control.
You're all right, Killer, you're all right.
Warren back for Kucherov, right circle. In front for Point. Shot a wide right. Hedman keeps the puck alive. Cross-ice pass. Oh! And a glove save made by Price to rob Steven Stamkos.
Oh, man, how good is this?
Keep going, boys. We're rolling.
Beats Coleman to center ice off his skate. It'll slip for Goodrow. Across the Montreal line. High slot. Shoots block. Rebound. Coleman. Score! And it's 2-0 Lightning with 14:13 left in the second. Tampa with a lot of momentum right now.
Down but not out, the Canadians would push back.
Right on the puck. Go, Webby!
It's a break opportunity for Shea Weber. Shot. Glove save by Vasilevsky. Wides and fires. Blocked by Killorn, who just throws himself in front of that shot. And now there he goes, struggling over to the bench. What a block.
Boy, Killer!
Until finally, just a few minutes before the end of the second, Montreal would get a lucky bounce.
Bench run by a score! It deflected in front, and the Canadians are on the board.
A period where the Lightning really had the better of the play for most of the period, but Sherratt scores late. It's a one-goal game.
All right. For 5 minutes, we deviated from the plan. It was just 5 minutes, but that's all it takes. That's what that team is looking for. There's a formula to it. Now go out and execute it, right? And all's good, boys. Let's go. Come on.
Third period underway.
In the third period, Tampa Bay would again find its way and eventually finish off the Canadiens with a flourish.
Over to Kucherov. Puts a backhand at the net and it goes in! Woo! Huge goal for the Lightning to go up by two again.
Even without one of its leading scorers.
I was getting a little concerned, Phil, because I had not seen Alex Killorn in the third period. Remember, he blocked that shot in
right.
The second.
Hey, he can't go, boys!
Can't go.
Killer.
One for Kucherov. High slot. Hold. Shoot! Score! Kucherov!
Attaboy, Kuch.
What a shot by Kucherov, too. It's 4-1 Lightning. Still only one shot for the Canadiens here in the third period. Only 15 of the game.
Edmondson out. Get him out. Let's get him out.
Canadiens have killed 31 straight penalties.
Amazing.
Over 13 plus games.
Amazing.
Oh, goody!
Here's Kucherov across, scores! Bad angle goal, but it goes in! And Steven Stamkos on the power play has ended the penalty kill streak of Montreal. And game one goes to the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Not only is this an all-important win to set the tone for the series, it's also a statement win.
The moment is huge, and I thought there was one team that knew exactly how to deal with the moment, and there was one team that didn't. It's just one step, and we keep climbing the mountain, but unbelievable.
Hey, Nikita, obviously you guys haven't played them in a year. Like, anything kind of surprise you? Was there like a feeling out process in the beginning of the game?
You know, we just stick to our plan and try to play the same way full 60 minutes, and, you know, we don't think about them, and, you know, we have the system, we have the plan, and we stick to it.
Kucherov became the fifth player in NHL history to register multiple 30-point playoff seasons, joining Wayne Gretzky, Mark Messier, Jari Kurri, and Mario Lemieux.
That's one of the best players in the world shooting that puck, and he's so, so good.
Good evening, everyone. Glad you're with us as we get you set for Game 2 of the Stanley Cup Final between the Tampa Bay Lightning and Montreal Canadiens. Tampa Bay came away with a convincing 5-1 win over the Canadiens in Game 1. Alex Killorn out. Matthew Joseph in.
Okay, boys, we know our sets. All right, so nothing changes there. We're fast through the neutral zone, 20, 30, 40 seconds at a time, and it's just roll. All right, boys, come on now. Let's go.
You can see Andre Vasilevsky leading the bolts out to the ice.
Vasilevsky is so durable, so consistent. There's such an elite level that he brings to the crease.
Big one tonight, big one tonight. Let's go, Eric. You start us off.
Let's go, boys. All right, we are underway in Game 2, and quickly the puck behind the Canadiens' net. A little bit of a turnover there, and Montreal comes the other way.
Make sure puck's going ahead here.
Skate.
Here comes Suzuki, moving it on Vasilevsky, who kept the puck out.
Get out of
him.
Circuit
chip. That's blocked by Gallagher.
But that was a great desperation play.
Right from the start of Game 2, Montreal's desperation and urgency would keep Tampa Bay under constant pressure.
Better structure, boys! Better structure!
They still stay on it. They're not set.
Let's hold it in. Lightning really haven't gotten the puck settled down. Kucherov right circle.
Oh, they're really
being pursued. Kucherov looks to center, and it got knocked away by Weber, and down the ice it goes. Well, they're going aggressive, that's for sure.
Good job, boys. Twin is. Stay aggressive.
Face off win by the Lightning. Caulfield sends it out, and it's a break for Toffoli. Chernak trying to get back. Toffoli stopped by Vasilevsky.
And the first period comes to an end.
Lightning looked a little off in that first. They had some chances. At times, they looked pretty good. But I think you have to probably give more credit to Montreal.
All right. What's our issue? Bottom line is, like, D, you got to move and get pucks through. All right? They have 8 shot blocks already. We got to get those through. All right, fellas? We'll be fine. Come on.
An improved Canadiens team here in Game 2 so far.
Go! Take it out of his hand!
Yeah, Lightning haven't really had a shot on net this period, have they?
They haven't really had any zone time to
speak of. Time, nothing.
Don't do that.
It's time to get going here.
Drive it north, fellas! North!
As the game grinded on, the normally reliable Lightning offense would go missing, forcing Andre Vasilevsky to keep Tampa Bay in the game, still only one shot away from taking a lead.
The D active again for Tampa. Johnson moving out of the corner, back to Cirelli. Shot from Trump again, goal! They get off to a 1-0 lead.
Cirelli delivering this one. Fans loving it outside and inside. This is where you need the veterans in the group, Shea Weber, to say, hey, listen, guys, let's get to our game, maintain our game, let's go get one here ourselves.
We got him.
It'll come back to Suzuki. Canadiens get a good bounce score.
Yeah.
It's Nick Suzuki who's tied it.
Yes, Suzuki!
Devin O'Neill left in the second. It's 1-1, but the ice certainly has been tilted.
Lightning can't do anything.
Simplify the game, boys. Simplify it. Take it to them.
Fighting through perhaps their poorest performance of the playoffs, the championship-tested Lightning were fully aware of the importance of every shift, the importance of every scoring opportunity, and the importance of playing every single second.
Tend to go in the period, right wing Weber, has it blocked away by McDonough. Good roll, carries across the blue line, open right circle, no. Has it front, score!
What a goal by Blake Coleman!
He literally dove That is a heck of a goal.
3/10 of a second on the clock, and it's 2-1 Lightning.
Now, it is as basic as it can be. We've lost every battle. We are in the Stanley Cup Final. Nobody takes a shift off. Let's do this together. And on a quick side note, unbelievable play by you two. That was making a play. That was the break we needed. Now, capitalize on it. Let's go.
We're not defending anything. Stay in attack mode.
Play it.
F1's got to take the puck out of the D's hands coming up.
Still up a goal, despite being outplayed, the Lightning would continue to take everything Montreal would throw at them until good fortune came their way.
Edmondson by the Montreal net, a pass picked off Palat.
Score! It's 3-1 Lightning! Let's go!
So there you see it, the Tampa Bay Lightning take a 2-0 lead in the Stanley Cup Final, a 3-1 victory behind the outstanding goaltending of the Russian-born Andrei Vasilevsky.
I look at tonight, and there are some remarkable individual performances. Vasi being one, Coleman being another. Collectively, as a group, it was borderline unacceptable. Tonight was their night to take us down. We gave them a gift, and they couldn't do it. We're in the finals. Don't give them a gift again. All right, boys. Okay, so remember, early flight tomorrow at Passports. Remember your passports.
For the first time in 28 years, the Stanley Cup Final would return to Montreal, the mecca of hockey.
The last time a Stanley Cup Final game was played here in Montreal, the Canadiens were lifting the Stanley Cup in 1993. Tonight, they find themselves in a 2-0 hole after dropping the first two games of the series in Tampa.
This is a must-win for the Montreal Canadiens. Yes, in round one, they came back from being down 3-1 to the Toronto Maple Leafs. You go down 3-0 to Tampa Bay Lightning, it's pretty much curtains.
Now listen, the game's gonna go, right? There's no sitting here like picking and choosing who we're playing against. Man up against who you have. You win your shift, win every shift. Play predictable here, fellas. We're getting close to the finish line. It's gonna get harder each time. Game this out here, boys, let's go.
Scene for the first Stanley Cup Final game in July. First in 10,250 days in Montreal. The first time ever below the 24 Cup banners at the Bell Center.
After quarantining for COVID-19 and missing the Canadiens' previous six games, head coach Dominique Ducharme was back behind the bench for game three.
Let's get close to the puck, support here. Let's go.
Okay, white on the ice first.
Puck is dropped. We are underway.
At the start, Andrei Vasilevsky would continue his brilliance in goal, allowing Tampa Bay's quick strike offense an opportunity to grab the early lead.
Ruda from the back tees scores!
No, Jay Ryan! Keep going, baby!
Once again, the Lightning have scored first.
And Tampa silences the crowd here in Montreal.
Cirelli, big shift here, boys. Big one, big one.
Just over a minute later, an unlikely error by veteran Eric Staal would give the Lightning their first power play of the game.
Eric Staal for the Canadiens. Over the glass.
It's a penalty here. Eric Staal's going to go to the box.
Montreal penalty, 21, 2 minutes delay of game. Be ready, be ready.
Dropping the power play, center point to Hedman.
Shoots, score! Off Bryson in! A power play goal for the Lightning, and they have a 2-0 lead. Nothing changes in our game. Nothing changes.
Hey, got it in.
Dominique Ducharme calling timeout. Not the start the Canadiens wanted, that's for sure. Two long-range shots beating Price.
Just calm down. It's 56 minutes to play. 56. The old game to play yet. All right? Let's go back one play at a time here. One play at a time. That's it. All right, let's go.
Stick to our plan. Hey. Hey, we're defending nothing. We're defending nothing. Stick with it.
Not entirely satisfied with its stellar start, Tampa Bay would keep pressuring Carey Price and the Canadiens.
Chernak open, shoots, and he missed wide left. Rebound nearly went in. The puck was in the blue paint. Wow. Price knocked it away.
But with the first period winding down, Montreal would finally get on the board, cutting the Lightning lead in half.
Back the other way comes Deneau. He's got Gallagher breaking. Deneau over the line. Scores! Phil Deneau's got his first of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Not 17-12 in favor of Montreal. But they trail 2-1 after 20 minutes here at Bell Center.
We reacted well after the two goals. No, we just need to win the second period. We'll be in position to win the game in the third. All right? It's still a long game. Stick with it.
Make sure we're smart on our changes here in the second. Smart on our changes. Keep flooding. Keep hitting the weak side. We had some great breakouts there. Hell of a period, boys. Let's continue it. Let's go now. Come on.
Small plays will lead us to big plays, boys. Let's get close to the puck. Support there. Let's go.
Second period underway.
Come on, fellas! Poise with the puck, fellas!
Early in the second period, a sloppy line change would prove costly for the Canadians.
Canadians start a change and a stretch pass.
Go! Go!
Pulled in, pass in front, scores!
Yeah! Maya, Maya!
A quick line change by the Lightning! And it led to a 2-on-0! Kucherov has made it 3-1!
Less than 2 minutes later, John Cooper's pregame fourth line shuffle would pay off in a big way.
Nice pass, 2-on-1, Joseph with Johnson. Rebound scores, Tyler Johnson.
Yeah, let's go!
Two quick strikes, just like the first period. It's 4-1 Lightning.
John Cooper deserves a huge assist on that goal.
What a move by John Cooper. On the road, gets Johnson off the wing, gets him on the fourth line at center.
And he's looked so much better.
In the third period, Tyler Johnson would again prove his coach a prophet, adding another chapter to his storybook night.
Tyler Johnson counters across the blue line to the slot, shoots, a man, rebound, score! Tyler Johnson!
Wow.
Tyler Johnson!
That's a huge one, man.
His second goal tonight, it's 5-2 Lightning!
Behind the seventh multi-goal game of Johnson's playoff career, the Lightning would prove to be too much for the Canadiens.
Time winding down here in Montreal. Lightning over the Canadiens, 6-3. Tyler Johnson and the Lightning now one win away from their second consecutive Stanley Cup title.
There's a reason Tyler Johnson's trophy case is fairly full. It's because he's an ultimate team player. Roles change and you have to adapt, and nobody's done it better than Tyler. And I'm extremely happy for the win. I might be a little happier for Tyler Johnson.
Hey, what is this? G-Dub!
Out since suffering a broken fibula in the series opener, Alex Killorn returned to the ice during warm-ups prior to Game 4 with a steel rod in his surgically repaired leg. But the player dubbed the warrior by Steven Stamkos for even attempting to come back would need more time to heal.
Alex Killorn did take part in warm-ups, but will not play.
With the Stanley Cup in the building, the Lightning looked to sweep the series, but to close out the Canadiens and Montreal, they'd have to overcome a resilient team that had already come back earlier in the playoffs, topping Toronto after trailing 3-1.
And the Montreal Canadiens have completed the comeback! Shock and awe in Toronto!
Let's be on top of those guys all night. When it's time, win your battles, win your one-on-ones, make sure we have a guy going at the net on the rush all the time, and net front presence in the ozone, all right?
So three things: process over outcome, get rid of the white noise. The only thing that matters is the guys in this room, and then no mercy. Go get them.
Game 4 from Bell Center in Montreal. Tampa Bay Lightning lead the series 3-0. The Lightning have scored first in every game. They have never trailed.
Hey, be ready for the pressure.
Have a good game, man.
Come on, boys, get out there.
To start Game 4, Tampa Bay would come out on the attack. But on this night, Carey Price would simply refuse to let in an early goal.
Weber loses it behind the net, pass it for a big stop as the Lightning nearly strike early again.
The shot attempts are 13-0 in favor of the Lightning.
Nice start, boys, out of the way!
Late in the first period, the Canadiens would finally give their hometown fans a reason to celebrate.
Suzuki dropping it back for Caulfield. And now Suzuki once again. Out in front. Star! Anderson! First lead of the series for the Montreal Canadiens.
And after a pedestrian-like offensive first period, the Canadiens just kind of finding their game a little bit here late in the first period.
In the second, as both teams continue their aggressive play, tempers would flare.
Vasilevsky gave him a shot.
Ain't nothing, baby.
But late in the period, with Montreal clinging to a one-goal lead, the Lightning would finally get to Carey Price.
Coleman, right circle. Shoot, save Price. Rebound in front. Good run. Score! What a pass by McDonough to Barkley. Goodrow, it's 1-1.
That's what happens when you get to the inside. That's how you do it.
Second period comes to an end. 40 minutes in the books here in Montreal.
We don't know if this is the last period of the game. All right? We don't know. There might be more periods. Just keep being predictable. All right? Be predictable and no mercy, boys. Let's go.
Well, comes down.
Yeah,
to this.
If you can win this period, Phil, as you often say, you win the Stanley
win
Cup.
The Stanley Cup.
Canadians looking to stay alive and force a game five in Tampa.
Evans to the point. Romanov shooting. Scores! Alexander Romanov!
The Canadians go back on top.
Hey, keep getting up in the rush.
As the clock wound down, Tampa Bay in its fourth line look to regain its lost momentum.
To the offensive zone,
shoot
right
it,
circle.
Kid.
Let's look at Maroon! Score!
Ben Maroon! And this game is tied up 2-2 with 6:12 left.
But elation by the Lightning would quickly turn to concern for a fallen teammate.
Block got high sticked.
Right there at Shea Weber.
And the Lightning are going to get a power play 4 minutes worth here.
And with 1:01 left to go in game four, Tampa have a 4-minute power play.
Unable to take advantage of the man advantage, Tampa Bay would nonetheless head to the locker room, knowing overtime would still begin with a power play.
All right, don't know what's going to happen here, fellas, but let's get this for Pally here, boys. All right, boys, let's go.
If the Lightning score the next goal, they will win their second consecutive Stanley Cup.
Hey, don't take anything for granted. Don't take anything for granted. Make sure we're working.
Right? Early in overtime, the Lightning would continue their relentless assault. But when Carey Price refused to yield and the power play ended, it was Josh Anderson who seized the moment for Montreal.
Gotta get out of there. Gotta get out of there.
Anderson scores! Canadians stay alive! And there will be game five!
I think the fan base would have loved if we would have come home with the Stanley Cup tonight. That's paramount. I think it's icing on the cake if you can do it at home, but there's no guarantees. And it's weird. Maybe it's set up. Maybe this is the way it was meant to be. And that's how it's going to play out. But two teams still got to play the games. And the game's decided in the trenches. And hopefully we can give our fans that gift.
Back in Tampa for Game 5, there was excitement in the air, with the Lightning now having the opportunity to clinch the series at home.
Tonight, we have the chance to win the freaking cup at home!
We had an opportunity last game in Montreal to win it, and we didn't. You want to win so bad, and you're so pissed off about last game, but tonight, it's an opportunity. It's an opportunity to win in front of our fans.
Loud it up in here!
While Tampa Bay has a chance to repeat as Stanley Cup champions, one team member has already achieved that feat. With a Lightning win, Pat Maroon would become the first player in nearly 40 years to win three straight cups.
We all come in the league and we want to win as many Stanley Cups as we can.
We have to empty the tanks tonight and find a way. I'm ready to go. This is what I dreamt of my whole life.
Come on, boys, eh? Let's go.
All right, boys. In the end, it's our will. It's our will and our attitude to take them out, that'll be everything. They will, at some point tonight, because of you, they will decide to lose. It'll happen at some point. If you play the same way, with the same grit and the same passion you've done for 2 years, they will choose to bow out. Make them do it. Let's go.
There of anticipation and celebration here at Emily Arena.
The Lightning won it last year at an FC Arena in Edmonton, Alberta. Over 18,000 in attendance tonight here in Tampa.
And this building is alive. Here we go, game number five.
Hey, guys, just don't dump me, okay? Guys, down and down, let's go.
Game five in Tampa.
Good hit.
Underway.
Good hit. Move it. Battle, battle. Boy, that way, Colby. Keep imposing your will, boy. Keep imposing your will.
Coleman and Anderson get feisty.
It has been a physical period.
Want to go?
He's got to be a better player for me to play.
Yeah, right. Double your boys, bud.
Let's go.
Double. That's enough. That's enough. Let's go.
From the cross, Edmund trying to clear. Gregory Coleman, but picked up there. Penalty coming.
Let's go. Let's go. It's 17. Okay.
In a testy opening period, Tampa Bay would draw three penalties.
Lightning are coming off that 0-for-5 on the power play in game number four.
Good drop, right wing circle.
But when the power play woes continued,
a shot right out of the, save by Trice.
The Lightning would head to the locker room with nothing to show for it, despite outshooting the Canadiens 13-4.
Keep the tactic, Blue. Keep the tactic.
Take it up a little more. Take it up a little more.
Strong side shots are good. Other than that, boys, just stay with it. It's a long haul here, fellas. Just not one period. Just keep staying with it, fellas. Let's go.
No.
McDonough cutting for the net. Looking for the redirect for point.
Now
here's Sherrod cutting wide with a shot. Kicked out by Vasilevsky.
It's ID.
Approaching 7 minutes of this second period.
Hurry back.
Still awaiting the icebreaker in D5.
The team scoring first has won all four games in this series.
With the vocal crowd thirsting for a goal, and Montreal keeping Tampa Bay's big stars in check, an unlikely hero would step forward to steal the show.
We can lose! Ah!
Six-man scrum. And it comes loose for McDonough. Ryan McDonough across. Here comes a chip and that scores! It is the rookie, Ross Colton.
You watch Colton after that scrum. Once McDonough gets it, Colton goes right to the net. Tremendous work there by the Lightning on the wall. Tremendous heads-up play by Colton to get to the net. Ross Colton gives the Lightning a 1-0 lead in game five.
It speaks to the depth of their club. Guys like Johnson, Boudreau, Coleman. Tonight it's Ross Colton.
Good job getting pucks behind him. It was an unreal job on the goal. They will be pressing. Now it's a period. Now it's your will versus their skill. All right, will this out, because I told you, they will choose to lose at some point. Make them. Let's go, boys.
Lightning lead the series 3-1, the game 1-0.
For the Lightning, hockey immortality is now only 20 minutes away. But Montreal isn't going to go quietly into the night.
Canadiens need a goal. And now the outlet pass for Anderson. Moving it on Vasilevsky, who makes the stop.
Such a contrasting atmosphere to 282 days ago when the Lightning beat the Dallas Stars to claim the 2020 Stanley Cup.
Protect the middle ice.
In the third period, as the clock continues ticking, the Lightning would live up to their coach's words, showing willpower, determination, and toughness.
Team remaining. Puck comes back out for Weber, a drive. And giving up his body to make the play that time was Barkley Goodrow.
Out of way, Goody! Out of way, Goody!
5.5 remaining. Ross Colton with the game's only goal. And now Colton and the Lightning looking to win the cup tonight here in Tampa. the oldest trophy competed for by professional athletes in North America.
We're down to 4 minutes remaining in the third.
Go, go!
Only two shots here in the third period for Montreal. Twice off to the bench, extra skater on. Back out it comes to Toffoli. He shoots, Vasilevskiy the save.
Rebound, and it's knocked away off the stick of Vasilevskiy.
Final minute, third period here in Tampa.
Rebound is going to come to Toffoli, left circle. Center point, Petrie. Shoots, block!
Goodrow again, under a half minute to go. The clock continues to tick away. Deneau to the side of the net, into the paint, and out!
Lightning strikes twice! The Tampa Bay Lightning win their second straight Stanley Cup!
They have done it! They have gone back to back!
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
John Cooper said, do you want to win it once or do you want to be special? And the Lightning as repeat champions will be in the special class.
Never be able to replicate last year's feeling because it was the first, but we never got this.
He and his team had more than their share of heartbreak before they got to this point and are back in the winner's circle.
Not since the 1970s has a goaltender played every game in a back-to-back run. Andre Vasilevskiy, you are the Conn Smythe Trophy winner.
Five consecutive series wins for Vasilevskiy that end with a shutout, which is remarkable.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
To win this back-to-back, this is an incredible accomplishment.
You went through 65 days in a bubble and then back on the ice 2 months later is an unbelievable accomplishment. This is the best back-to-back any team has accomplished in any sports. And that's a credit to all you guys. It's a credit to the coaching staff. It's just amazing. So, guys, congratulations. Enjoy it. Coach, enjoy it.
This group is just amazing. I mean, look at our record after a loss in the playoffs. That's unheard of. Like, that's, what is it, 14-0 going back to last year? That's just, that is unheard of in professional sports. And that's just the group that we have, so I can't be more proud.
Hey, one last thing. G-Dub!
We know going forward that this was realistically probably the last time all of us are going to play together. I can't say how much that motivated us. It's not very often you get this chance to play with a team like we did. No matter what happens from here on out, this group is going to be etched in history forever.
Been living in a dream world these last few days. It's what you dream about when you're a kid, and it's what you dream about when you get older and you come into the league. You know, this means a lot to our community, and to be able to share with them today is unbelievable.
sitting here last year going through the boat parade and we're like, this is the most amazing thing ever. And now to be in the exact same position, what is it, 9, 10 months later? It's unbelievable.
Last year was such a special experience because it was our first championship. But the one thing we were robbed of was doing it in front of our family, our friends, and our fans. When you win a championship, you may have a tendency to say, okay, we've won, and take a breath. This team was so hungry to win another one, they weren't going to be denied, and we couldn't have written the script any better than what happened this year.